Hi everybody, it's Lisa from Lisa's Paper Passion. Excuse me. I am really super excited to present to you my second design team project for Gladys for It's Heart of a Gipssy Soul and Garden of Eden Life 1. And this month we're continuing the theme of Bonjour Paris. And it's all about French, and I wanted to make my project a little bit different. It's not a mini album because my first project was a mini album. So the second project, Gladys always likes for us to do whatever creative project that we want. So I was really happy in doing that. What I used was, this isn't the project, but this is the kit. This is the large Bonjour Paris ornate album kit. And as you could see, I haven't shown this in a previous video because, like I said in my other video, which I'm publishing, that I forgot and it was totally my boo-boo. So this is the entire kit except for one page that you'll see in a few minutes. And that, you know, like I always say about Gladys's kits, they're chock full of thick dyes of this, the chipboard. And then she includes all the paper like you could see, and you can use the front and the back. And this particular album is really nice. It's big. And I'm still planning on doing something with this on my own. But for my design team project, I wanted to show you everything that you get in this kit, and then I'll show you what I did with one of the pieces. And in the kit itself, I know the plastic's kind of not that attractive, but let me show you real quick what came in the kit. And I didn't use all of it because Gladys is so generous. She sends us everything, even if we're not going to use that particular kit. Because there are, let's see, there's Linda, myself, and Malika. And then every month she has a couple of really creative guest design team members. So between all of us, we get to kind of pick and choose the kits that we're going to use. And I use the little one for the month of September. So this large one, actually, she sent to me as a gift. So that's how generous my friend is. But these are all the extra pieces that came in it. You get a large Eiffel Tower, and I love these. And you'll see how I use the little one on my design team project. And, of course, like I've said in the past, you get all the extra paper that comes with it because these come in really handy for, you know, other things that you're using, like pockets or other reasons to use them in your project. And then this kit comes with the birdcage die, the little heart with the key, and just all sorts of goodness in here. The bird, this little frame, and then she sends you all these extra pieces too, which I love to use. I mean, look at that. That's like, you know, you could just cut that out and use it as a heart. So, oh, and this one too. Okay, so I'm going to put this aside. I wanted to show you real quick how huge this was because it's gorgeous. It's like, let's measure it. It's a good 11 and a half inches. So if you're planning on doing a large album, like for a wedding or for a gift for Christmas, for any occasion, this large album is perfect. Okay, so what I did is, of course, I'm a Tilda fanatic. And I wanted to make my second design team project for the month a French Tilda theme. And I used this paper. It's called Corner Shop from Tilda. I love this paper. I don't use it often because it's just precious to me. But in this case, oh, I left this in here. Take this out. In this case, I wanted to use it for my design team project because it was just beautiful. And I see I treasure like every little paper that I even that I don't use. Okay, so ta-da! You're looking at the back of my project. And I worked on it this morning, and I'm surprised at how quickly it went and how clean I kept my space. Usually when I'm creating, and there's just like stuff everywhere, but I'm proud of myself for keeping my area clean because it doesn't usually happen. So anyway, so this is the back of it. So what I did, as you can tell, is I used one of the pages from the kit, and this is the back side, and I did use the paper that she provided to me on the back because I did want it covered. I didn't want like bare chipboard on the back of it. And she even punches all the holes. Of course, I didn't need that in for this particular project, so that's okay that it's on the back and it's not going to show. So you can easily use this kit, her kits, as mini albums, or you can take it apart and do banners. I mean, we between Malika and Linda and I, we try to show you all the different ways you can use the kits. Okay, so I know you're dying to see the front. So this is my Tilda inspired, it's not a banner, I guess you call it a pennant if it's one piece. Okay, turning it over. Here it is. It came out beautiful, I think. But of course, please chime in and you tell me what you think of it. So the corner shot paper that I used that I just show you from the pad, I really like that one page, and I know other ladies have used it too. Let me show you what page I'm talking about. And it looks like the shop, like a storefront. Oops, something flew out. This is the page that I used. So I just traced the chipboard part on this paper, and I really wanted like this, storefront look. To my pennant. So that's what I used. And I'll point out the pieces from Gladys's store. Of course, the chipboard itself, the paper that on the back is from her store. And this beautiful lace on top, this white lace trim is from Gladys's store. And I used two pieces. And the way I did it to make it, show on both sides is I just glued one this way and then one facing this way so that I had like a two-sided trim. And then I put this favorite, this is my favorite trim from my stash. I love this stuff. I put that in the middle, and I wanted to keep the theme pink because this is enchanted forest flowers, and this is a cutout from the paper that I used. And then on the back right here, this back part is a piece from the kit. So I just covered it with Tilda paper. And I liked how that came out. And let's see. This, of course, the Eiffel Tower piece is from the kit. I'm gonna put the light down a little bit. I think that's much better. This Eiffel Tower piece is a chipboard piece that comes in a kit. And to continue on the theme of flowers, I covered it with Prima flowers. Oops, this little piece fell out. And these flowers were white. I love my new color bloom spray. These were gifted to me from Pam LaMarche. I hope I said your name right. I love this stuff. Because I didn't want to use just plain white flowers on the pennant. Actually, let me show you what the flowers are. They're these flowers. So I just painted them pink with the bloom spray and hit them with the heat gun, and they dried quickly, and I was able to line up my Eiffel Tower. And then this is a die cut from the paper pad. It's a bird cage, and just added a little bit of trim to it, and just some goodies from my stash. These are some resin pieces that I made. And in the Totally Tilda group, we're having a resin swap. So this is a frame with a little ballerina in the back. And then there's a different type of frame on this side. And this will be a gift for someone who loves Tilda. And I made a little seam binding holder. And I'm thinking about adding a flower to it, but I was gonna add one of my Wanda flowers to it like this to hang it up. So I'm still kind of debating whether or not to add that because I don't want it to detract from this pennant project itself. But I think it's far enough. Like if somebody hung it on their wall, I think it's far, the flower's far enough from this stuff going on that it'll be okay. But Still debating that, but anyway, thank you for stopping by and checking out my design team project for Gladys. I hope you like it. I hope that inspires you. And I'm going to be posting pictures online. So check out her store. I'll post a link to this this kit. And then, of course, if you get the kit and decide not to make a mini album, you can make a bunch of these. And these are really fun to make. And let me know if you have any questions. Please subscribe if you're not already a subscriber to my channel. And have a blessed day. Thank you. Bye.